In this video, I will illustrate how to write a recursive formula for a sequence. But before that, let us first look at the following terms. Number one, sequence. A list of numbers in a specific order. Examples, letter A, 3, 7, 11, 15. There is actually a pattern, plus 4, 7, plus 4, 11, plus 4, 15. Letter B, 5, 12, 19, 26. There is a pattern, plus 7, 12, plus 7, 19, plus 7, 26. Next, finite sequence. A sequence with a last term. It has a definite number of terms. Examples, letter A, 5, 7, 9, 11. 11 is the last term. And there are 4 terms, 1, 2, 3, 4. In letter B, the last term is 16. And there are 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 5 terms. Next, infinite sequence. A sequence without a last term. It has no definite number of terms. Examples, letter A, 7, 12, 17, 22. 22 is not the last term. The 3 dots here indicate that there are some more terms. So, there is no definite number of terms. Here, letter B, 5, 9, 13, 17. 17 is not the last term. The 3 dots indicate that there are some more terms. Each value in a sequence is called a term. For example, here, 7 is a term, 12 is a term, 17 is a term, and 22 is also a term. A recursive formula is used to determine the nth term from the preceding term. We are going to find the recursive formula of these two sequences. Let's solve the first one. The first term is 3. Let us represent it by a sub 1, and then the second term by a sub 2, the third by a sub 3, then the fourth by a sub 4. So a sub 1 is 3. That's our first term. A sub 2 is 7, which is 3 plus 4. 3 plus 4 is 7. A sub 2 is 3 plus 4, but what is 3? 3 is A sub 1 plus 4. Next, A sub 3. A sub 3 is 11. To get 11, add 4 to 7. So, 7 plus 4 is equal to 11. So, A sub 3 is equal to 7 plus 4. But what is 7? 7 is A sub 2 plus 4. So a sub 3 is a sub 2 plus 4. Next, a sub 4. A sub 4 is 15. 15 is 11 plus 4. So 11 plus 4 is equals to 15. A sub 4 is 11 plus 4, but 11 is a sub 3 plus 4. Let us analyze this. This is 1 less than 4. This is 1 less than 3. This is 1 less than 2. So, if we represent this by n, this must be n minus 1 plus 4. This is the recursive formula. So, the recursive formula is a sub n is equals to a sub n minus 1 plus 4, where a sub 1 is equal to 3. This represents the preceding term. This means to get the next term, add 4 to the preceding term. Next, 5, 12, 26, 54. Let us represent our first term by a sub 1, and then this one by a sub 2, by a sub 3, and then this by a sub 4. So, a sub 1 is equal to 5. If we add 7 to 5, you get 12. 5 plus 7 is 12. But adding 7 to 12 won't equal 26. 26 plus 7 is not 54 either. So, if adding a number will not result to the next term, try multiplying and then adding. Time is 2. 10. 10 plus 2. 12. Time is 2. 24 plus 2. 26. Time is 2 plus 2. 54. So, a sub 2 is equals to 2 times 5 plus 2, which is equals to 12. But 5 is a sub 1 plus 2. So a sub 2 is 2 times a sub 1 plus 2. Next, a sub 3. A sub 3 is 26. 2 times 12 is 24 plus 2 is 26. So, a sub 3 is 2, but 12 is a sub 2 plus 2. So, a sub 3 is 2 times a sub 2 plus 2. Next, a sub 4. Our a sub 4 is 54. So, 2 times 26 is 52 plus 2 is equal to 54. So, a sub 4 is equal to 2 times 26, but 26 is a sub 3 plus 2. So, a sub 4 is 2 times a sub 3 plus 2. Let us analyze this. This is 4 minus 1. 4 minus 1 is 3. 3 minus 1 is 2. 2 minus 1 is 1. So, if we replace this by n, this must be n minus 1 plus 2. This is the recursive formula. The recursive formula is a sub n is equal to 2a sub n minus 1 plus 2, where a sub 1 is equal to 5. This represents the preceding term. So to get the next term, multiply this by 2 and add 2.